It's extremely hard to find a place to do my video. Hello everyone, I'm doing ASMR. I've tried to find something to rip and I found something that belonged to my ex. She gave it to me and I thought maybe it's about time to let go on certain things. I've recently had a dream, slight nightmare. It was almost as if I was still in a relationship with this person, and it was almost as if nothing had happened, and it was a very strange dream. Forcibly kissed her in that dream. It was so weird. And by the time I ran out to try and get to her, I think after catching up, it was so weird. She just disappeared. Unlike some vehicle, they do say, I was recently told that if you're dreaming about a person, it may mean, it may not mean that you still have affection for that person. But the thing is that I don't want that person back, even though I fell in love with the person I met, rather than a person that person had changed to. I'm just gonna rip what she wrote. So I don't know even how I feel about any of this, to be honest. Not 100% about this, doing something like this, because what she wrote back then is when she was a complete loving, kind person that I knew. So I feel sort of guilty in a way, but because I did kind of promise a few people to do ASMR, I don't know, because it's like I cling on to certain things and I can't. It's just, she was like a pure angel. She was just, she was amazing. I loved her to death. And I really hope I didn't jump to assumptions that she was cheating on me, but I had this feeling and I felt convinced. And people were telling me things and she said that they may be right. And she told me in a weird tone of voice when she last called me, was that, I don't want to hurt you. And that's when I was right, right, that's fucking red flags right there. That is red flag alert telling me something. Something's wrong. I had thoughts in my head whether she was cutting herself, whether or not she did the same thing like we did to her ex-boyfriend that she had no feeling toward. I hated the thought, but I kept being delusional. She was the very first person I was sexually and emotionally attracted to. I confided my trust in her. I can't even explain it. I can't even describe. For the first time, I actually felt someone was there. Someone who could love me. Someone who changed everything in a good way. I'll be reading out what she said back then. Sharing this on camera anyway. She used to call me Natalie Chan and she made this for me. This pockets as well, where she put things in. To Natalie Chan, I made this cute little booklet for you to show that I care no matter how small the little book is. The little pocket opens. I love you. Hope this puts a smile on your face. I remember when I first had. I remember. Please always be safe. If I lost you, I don't know what I would do. I just can't go on without you. Like in my dream. Are you eating well today? I hope so. Don't force yourself, but try to stay healthy. Remember, that means mental health too. So please wait for me, and I'll wait for you, because I need you more than ever. Does this page feel like deja vu, lol? XD, you're so kawaii. I'm so lucky to have you. You're so important to me. Do you know that? The question mark's given to me. I don't know why. For fuck's sake. Puffy face. XD, joke. Hope this writing isn't too small to read. No, it's never too small to read. Think. As long as you're happy, then everything should be okay. Nosebleed. The thing is, I never thought I was the one. I was always thinking that maybe you started to get insecure about our relationship, so I thought instead of me thinking that, the others. I felt like saying something like that to you. I did love this though. Love him.
Look in the mirror. You are my purpose. You got it off by heart. You are my purpose for being here.
Without you, I am nothing. It's okay to feel sad or depressed. Just let it all out. I'm always here for you. And then that turned out to be a lie. In the end, your words were always there instead of you. Good way, bad way, life. So don't even think about leaving this world without me. Are you happy now though? I kept your promise. I'm still alive.
Blushing or squealing. Oh, you knew that I was crying instead. Don't cry, please. I know you get emotional over this stuff. Yeah,
you're just still fucking crying.
I hate you. But I love you. And here, can't wait for Super Love Season 2. Don't remember that. I need it. I ship it. Don't we all? I ended up hating the ending. Okay. You're my world. You mean everything to me. This book never ends. Like our love, the puns are too much. Never too much. To be with you is by
I don't know how I really feel about all this.
Damn.